Well, I'm out here on Hodgenton Island, where I haven't been in quite a while, maybe 6 or 7 weeks, trolling out towards the main river with my Mirrodene, and lo and behold, a snook came out and struck it. Very good start for the day. Very good start. Managed to get the boat out here without getting bitten up with mosquitoes. Managed to avoid any minor traffic accidents on the way here, unlike the last time. So this is great. Not a big snook, but heck, I am very happy to catch this guy. All right, let me get him off the hook and back where he came from. Been following this school of mullet. You see them occasionally splashing. I've heard that redfish tend to hang around schools like that, sometimes underneath them, sometimes along the edge. So I've been casting around the edge of the school and right through the school, trolling through it, but nothing so far. I'm out here on the main river, but it's plows are on the bank. Pull over to the end of that point over there, and then maybe switch back to spinning tackle. Put on plastic shrimp and a float, and then maybe drift back across here. I catch some sea trout that way. Did see quite a nice snook cruise past me earlier, probably 25 to 30 inches. I was using the fly rod at the time, and I did what I could to get the fly out in front of him as he got closer, but I'm not sure I really got it to where he could see it. At least I didn't spook him, but it was nice to see that fish like that was back in there. About 1 o'clock. Could use a few more bites, but we'll see what happens. Well, I put on a popping fly, a popper just like I use for bass, because I saw a lot of fish coming up to the surface. Didn't know what they were, but hooked something. I'm not sure what this guy is. Might be a small tarpon. Let me get him in and no, not a tarpon, but I believe it's a small ladyfish. Boy, did that give me a good squeeze. There's a bunch of them out here, so let me get my popper back, get this guy in the water, and I can see if I can catch some more. He was a real fighter. Jumped about half a dozen times, just like a tarpon would, and pulled real hard. All right. All right, guy, let me get that thing out of your mouth and catch some more of your brothers and sisters. I'm back in Blind Creek now. I have a feeling that anything much less is going to happen. Let me say that again. I have a feeling that not much is going to happen. When I was out in the bay at the mouth of the creek, I noticed that there were a lot of fish hitting the surface. That's why I switched to that to the fly rod and the popper and then caught that ladyfish. A little while after that, I saw that some water was coming out from a large culvert connected to one of the mosquito control ponds around here. There was a lot of water coming out of it, and quite a lot of fish were congregating around that culvert where the water was coming out. And I went back in there and threw the popper and got one fairly large fish to hit it, but then I struck back a little too soon and pulled it out of his mouth and wasn't able to hook anything after that. But that gave me an idea that maybe back here in Blind Creek, some of the culverts that also lead back to mosquito control ponds would be emptying out water as the tide goes down. But so far, I haven't seen much action. There's very little water coming out of those culverts compared to what the one that was out on the bay. So that may be the reason. Kind of wish I could get out on the bay again, but I don't think I'll go back again. I think I'll just stay here and just fish along the shoreline, see if maybe I can pick up another snook or so. We'll see.